Joe David this morning from Elementos. Joe, good morning.
Morning, Andrew. How are you?
Good, Joe. Good to be speaking with you. More encouraging signs here for Oropesa. Further tin mineralisation zones intersected outside the existing resource here. Tell us a bit more about it.
Yeah, so I guess the background of this is we've been in control of the project for, you know, three and a half years now, and all our drilling up to date has been to within, I guess, the mineral resource. And, you know, we recently put out the mineral resource estimate of, you know, 19.6 million tonnes at about 0.4% tin, which is one of the core fundamental blocks that'll go into our DFS. So basically, once we got that completed earlier this year, we actually finally sent the drill rigs out outside the resource, and we've already published a few of those results from up in the northwest of the deposit. The majority of results we've released this week are actually from the southeast part of our resource, from our deposit. And again, we're hitting very good grades of tin. So outside the resource, hole 44, as published, hit about 19 meters of nearly 0.5% tin from 33 meters of depth. So again, that's very good tin mineralization, higher than our resource grade, nice and shallow. So I guess it's showing, while it won't form part of our DFS study, it's certainly an indication to our shareholders in the market, this tin resource will extend both in the northwest and in the southeast. And, you know, the story continues to grow at Oropesa.
And you mentioned the DFS. So how's that study? Where are we at with it?
Yeah, we're really at the pointy end. I'm not sure if I look tired, but certainly a lot of work getting done by myself and the rest of the team to get that completed and out into the market. You know, we're still aiming for that to be released in June, before the end of the financial year. So certainly major focus for us, all the key elements coming together. We're really in the back end of the final cranking of the numbers and the reporting phase. So yeah, as I said, very much looking forward to getting that out into the market, as well as the DFS. Just to remind everyone, that will come with the project's first JORC ore reserve statement, which will be fantastic for to be able to promote the project, that we have technical and economic ore body ready for development.
Yeah, June not too far off, Joe. And meanwhile, how's the tin price been performing?
Yeah, tin price is holding in there, I think, Andrew. So we're at about $25,000-$26,000 on the London Metal Exchange. We're high. We're close to $30,000 on the Shanghai market. That's very good because, you know, with the global, global inflation and demand dropping off in a number of sectors, tin price is holding in there at, you know, quite good prices. And that really is evidence because of the supply side. So as we know, and as a lot of the commodity forecasters are now saying, you know, the tin price is forecast to go $30,000 and above. That's because of the supply side, and there's so many challenges on the supply side. I've spoken to you about a number of them before, but the additional one that popped up probably in the last month was the Myanmar tin concentrate that comes across the border in the south of China. The Myanmar state government there has put in bans to stop both legal and illegal mining of their resources, and that's stopping a lot of the flow of concentrate into the south of China. So, and China is obviously the largest refiner of tin, Myanmar being the third largest miner of tin. So again, major supply side challenges, and certainly something that the market appears to be starting to understand. And even when we're at a point of low demand, prices remain elevated. So as demand increases, as is forecast by, you know, the world moving to, you know, significant use of electronics and electrical infrastructure, prices certainly forecast to rise.
Good to speak this morning, Joe. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew. Appreciate your time.